In Mexico, they're almost a sacred institution. The mighty lime is used in drinks,
limoncito,
food, and, well, just about everything. In recent months, a big fall in production has meant that limes in fields like these are in hot demand and prices have shot up. Juan Liana Malpica says he's receiving 20 times as much for his limes as 6 months ago. Prices do normally rise at this time of year, but there are more important factors. There's the devastation caused by citrus disease, he says. And then there is climate change. With the arrival of winter, there has been a cold snap in neighboring states. And what I feel is most devastating are the price speculators. He also points to recent insecurity in the state of Michoacán, a top lime producer. Those most directly affected are Mexican consumers. I normally buy 2 kilos, this shopper says, but now I buy a half and only use them for absolute essentials. Mexico is the world's largest lime producer, and markets in the United States and Europe are also feeling the brunt. We're here on Manhattan's Upper West Side to gauge how some businesses are reacting to that price hike. Are you going to be paying more for your margarita?
Well, I can tell you this time last year, we were paying approximately $36 a case. Our first delivery this morning was $110 a case. Now, we've not passed that along to the guests and don't plan to.
All the same, with so many items on the menu dependent on limes, the chain of 19 restaurants says it will have to pay an extra $650,000 this year if prices stay the same. This means a big payday for those growers who have not been hit by shortages. Producers are going to invest their money in their own fields, this exporter says, because that's the way of improving. You can fertilize better. The Mexican government is also trying to ramp up future supply by introducing new methods to produce limes all year round. The government and farmers expect prices to begin falling in May. Their concern is that the recent experience may test the loyalty of consumers and businesses. Nick Parker, CNN. Tapaltzingo, Mexico.